Oh, come on. Outward mail center automation acceptance. What on earth does that mean? It's typical, isn't it? They came really quick last time, and this time I think maybe it's because they arrived at a weekend. They've taken absolutely ages. Oh, what was that? Okay, so in my last video, I designed a PCB to attach these RP2040-Zeros onto so I can run PicoMac and replace some of this wiring. And here they are. It's only taken less than 10 days to arrive. I was just hoping that they would arrive a bit sooner than they did. So exciting. Oh, it's funny when they arrive like this as individual boards. Yes! I had this horrible feeling they weren't going to have the cutout. All right, I like the way that they arrive on a strip, just like individual components would. Okay, so it looks all right. We've got an LED and a resistor on there. Then we've got the other line resistors across the bottom. USB mini, a mini USB, sorry. Just as an auxiliary power in. And then really the big thing is, will this fit in here? I was wondering whether they might have done this so it's a cutout, so that fits in the board completely, but it doesn't. So I've got to solder that in there. So let's get the soldering iron out and I'll do that. Okay, so we've got a new soldering iron tip again. Those Timu ones I had from before didn't last very long. So let's just do a bit of tip conditioner on that. There we go. Right, nice and shiny on that then. Let's put that down there so that I can burn myself on it later on. All right, so I think the first thing I need to do really is just unsolder the bits off this. So let's just get my little helping hands out for that. And this should be relatively easy to do. There's not a lot to see on this. I want to use this device because we know that this is working. So I don't want to try and do a new one in case you mess anything else up on it. But they come off easy. The idea of this is that I have it on there flat. So I've just got to be careful with any lumps of solder on there, which will stop it being flat against that. Because I'm actually soldering board to board here, if you see what I mean. I'll just put a bit of flux on. And I should have my desoldering wick, and we'll put a bit of flux on that as well. And just try and wick off any solder that's down there to keep that flat. So I think that's done it. Yeah, just a little bit there as well. Let's take that one off if I can. So I'll get some more of this, and which side do I want to put it on? Yeah, I want to put it on this side anyway. Just on the ones that I'm going to use, I think. So what am I going to use? I'm just going to use there. There's some on there already, so that's all right. Let's just do it down that bit and do it down the bottom bit there. And maybe I'll just put one over the top. So then this goes on with the buttons up. And I'm hoping that the flux will stick it down somewhat. I'm going to make sure that this is as square as I can. I think that looks all right. And I really hope when I put a blob of solder on this now that I'm not going to dislodge it. Put a little blob on that. I think that's as far as I can get it. That should have sealed it up now. Yeah, so now I can do the others. These should be easier now, so I'm just pushing the soldering iron into the little crevice in the side of the board, crenellation, and then just dropping the solder on the top point, top bit, and hopefully that should wick underneath because I'm heating the bottom pad up as well as the subboard pad up. That really sounded as if I knew what I was on about. Subboard, didn't I? The sub-assembly. Oh, look at me, engineer. Right, let's do these. and you know you've got a good amount of flux because the joints are really shiny after you've put them in. Let's just do this one again. Add a little bit more to that. I'm not going to bother soldering the others. Okay, so let's get that cleaned up. Quality acid brush. Okay, so if I've done this right, where I've soldered these on, we should see a little blob of solder. But just there, you've just got a little bit of solder coming through, so it's obviously gone underneath that through the pad. So hopefully that's all connected. I could sort of test these with a probe, but I think I'm just going to plug it in. So I've got a micro SD. Now, I'll let you into something. The reason I put a micro SD down here is because I've only normally got one USB-C wire out here. So I was being lazy. But yeah, if there was two, it would be fine. So I think if I plug this in, it should power up. So let's just... But there you go. I mean, the fact that that's working is really, really promising. Yeah, because that telltale only will work on my board. So it means I've got the wire in. It means, was it Arnold AK? It means I did fix the ground net on that. But that's working. Right. Okay, so what should I try next? Let's just check this. This is giving out 5 volts for the mouse. That will be one thing. Yeah, so the mouse is working, and then the big thing then, in fact I'll leave the mouse in, let's pop that away, I've finished soldering now. My little VGA screen, I'm going to do another little video about this. I think a couple of people have asked about it, actually it's pretty good value, but I'll introduce this in another video. I think it's on, let me just reset it to make sure it's on. Yeah. And then the other wire of that goes into here. So do we have a Mac when we plug it in? Ah! Yay! Right, let's turn him round. So there's the Pico Mac and definitely running. I'm going to need a bit of a space for a mouse here. Yeah, lovely. So, wow, look, sample memo, what's on this? July the 16th, 1984, finance meeting agenda. I'm trying to do that. Of course, the Apple didn't do that. Didn't know about scrolling mice, did it? Here are my comments on your proposal. Well, there's a very... a mental health party for finance sounds great. What is this? What is this madness? Okay, something that people who are... fictitious. Well, I hope they are. Let's just look at missile command again. So that works the way it did previously. Lovely. All right. So what do you reckon? I mean, this is still a bit messy, but that's just the general cables. And you know, it's actually a lot better than that, isn't it? My micro USB could go on there. I could put a barrel jack on there and do it from 5 volts anyway. But there you go. So that is the SpiderMaf RP2040-Zero using a WaveShare RP2040-Zero. But yeah, I've got a few of these boards left. I might put them in my Etsy shop if anyone's interested. Probably easier if it's in the UK. But I'll put a couple of these boards on. So I'll probably solder the Timu board on there and I'll flash them so that I know that they're working before they go off to anyone. And then you can play with them to your heart's content. So what could we do on this next? Well, I think probably the next thing to do is to add the SD card reader to it. So I might do that in a video later on. What I'd really like to do, and I don't know whether I'm clever enough, is completely remove the need for this RP2040-Zero and build my own RP2040 board. So this is just going to be then probably still the width of the connector, but I'd put all of the other circuitry off the 2040 actually on the board and get that built. That might be a project, probably wouldn't video that project because I think it would break a lot and there'd be a lot of revisions. But yeah, I'm really happy with this. So if you want to see some more Raspberry Pi 2040 projects, please subscribe. And I hope you enjoyed watching this mini series about getting Pico Mac working on one of these teeny boards. Bye.